Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you isolation between transmitter and receiver in radar system. See, in radar system, transmitter operates at very high power. That power is there in terms of few kilovolts to megavolts, while the receiver is operating at very low power. Received echo signal, that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt at antenna. So transmitter and receiver circuit, both should be isolated over here. Otherwise, transmitter circuit may damage receiver circuit. Here in this video, I'll explain you isolation by two techniques. One is by having two separate antennas, and second is by having usage of microwave devices. First of all, let us begin this video with first agenda, that is basics of isolation in between transmitter and receiver. In my last video, I have explained you CW radar system. With that CW radar system block diagram, I have not provided any isolation over here. See, here we have transmitter that is generating continuous wave with frequency F0. This signal is having very high power. Here, if any object is there, then there will be reflection towards antenna over here. If you observe transmitted signal over here, then that signal is having frequency F0 and power is very high. Power of transmitted signal is there in terms of few kilovolts to megavolts. Here reflected echo signal, that is having frequency deviation as if this object is having motion, and based on motion, deviation of frequency will happen as per F0 plus or minus FD, and reflected echo signal that is having very less power at antenna over here. That signal strength will be there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt to 10 to the power minus 15 volt. Here, if you observe, see, we are not having any isolation over here. Transmitted signal that is going towards antenna, and that can also go towards receiver over here. And received signal over here that is having very less power. So as if leakage is there from transmitter to receiver over here, then this leakage signal may damage receiver over here. So basically, we need to have isolation in between transmitter and receiver. So in some books, you might have observed some different block diagrams in which they might have added duplexer over here, or here you can have this same block diagram with the use of two separate antennas. One antenna will be connected with transmitter and another antenna that will be connected with receiver. Here, as I have told you, radar system operates with two sections. One is transmitter and second is receiver. Transmitter operates with high power, that is there in terms of few kilovolts to megavolts, and receiver operates at low power. That power is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt to 10 to the power minus 15 volt. So it is very essential to have isolation in between transmitter and receiver circuit. Otherwise, this radar system may not function properly, and you need to provide protection to receiver. That's why isolation of transmitter and receiver is compulsory. Now I'll explain you isolation by microwave devices. See, there are many microwave devices that one can use to have isolation. One of that is duplexer, where this duplexer is isolating transmitter and receiver circuit. And here, this antenna is used for transmission and reception. So single antenna is acting like a transceiver circuit, right? Here, we have many microwave devices that can be used as an isolator. Here one can use duplexer, directional coupler, circulator, matched T junctions, rat race junction. See, in matched T junction, one can have magic T, one can have E plane T, H plane T. All these devices that I have explained in my microwave engineering lecture series. Here right now consider, these are the devices that one can use it for isolation of transmitter and receiver, right? Here, there are a few issues that happens as if you use these devices. See, isolation provided by matched junction and rate rest junction, that is around 60 dB. But that is theoretical value. If you talk about practical isolation, then that is there up to 30 dB. So as if you have matched DT junction or rate rest junction, in that case, you will be having 60 dB isolation theoretically. But practically, when you install those devices over here instead of duplexer, at that time, that isolation will be there around 30 dB. As well as if you add these two devices, in that case, there will be loss of signal at transmitter as well as at receiver, and that loss will be there by 6 dB, right? So here around 6 dB loss that will happen as if you use these microwave devices, right? Now let us talk about isolation by two separate antennas. See, in bistatic radar system, we use two separate antennas, right? So separate antennas are there with transmitter and receiver circuit. So here there will be isolation in between transmitter and receiver as we are using two separate antennas. But there are some issues with this system even. See, usually in radar system, we use parabolic dish antenna, and size of parabolic dish antenna, that is very large, right? So if you use two separate antennas, in that case, you will be having excellent isolation. But along with isolation, you will be increasing overall size of radar system, right? So here, isolation can be provided with the use of two separate antennas, where you will be having excellent isolation over here, but overall size of the system will increase. Largest isolation that is possible as if you provide two separate antennas with transmitter and receiver. Here, greater than 80 dB isolation can be achieved using two separate antennas. So here you can have greater than 80 dB isolation, and that is not theoretical isolation, that is practical isolation. But isolation is also depending on few parameters. So one should know, see here, isolation in between transmitter and receiver due to two separate antennas is also depending on beam width of antenna. If you use antennas with very narrow beam width, in that case, isolation will increase. Why? The reason is, if you consider this transmitter antenna, if it is having broad beam width, in that case, here signal coupling will happen in between transmitting and receiving antenna. But as if beam width is very narrow over here, in that case, EM wave coupling in between TX and RX antenna, that will be very less, right? So narrow the beam width, more the isolation over here, right? As I have told you, see, if you use two separate antennas, then loss of signal is very low over here. Ideally, you can say that is zero, but it is increasing overall size of radar structure. The reason is, here we are having two separate antennas, right? So here you will have to understand system first. If you use microwave devices, in that case, you will be using single antenna only. But in that case, there will be issues of loss of signal as well as isolation issue. If you want to provide better isolation, in that case, you will be using two antennas. But here, overall size of the structure, that will increase. I hope you have understood isolation of transmitter and receiver in radar system. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.